Hey guys, welcome back. Previous video, we created the establishing shot for our cinematic. So to recap really quickly, if I play here in the cinematic viewport, we have a camera that kind of pushes in on a character that is animated, stands up and turns around and looks at the camera. So that's where we left off. It's our first shot, but we're going to keep moving on, moving right along here. In this video, what we're going to do is actually cut about here and use a different camera angle. And then we'll add a second character, we'll add more cameras. And by the end of this video, we'll have a series of three shots for our cinematic. So let's go ahead and continue. What we'll do for this is let's go to make sure that we're in the master sequence here. And I'm going to stretch this out. Whoops. I'm going to stretch this out to like there, just to make sure that we have the full thing there. We can also click on this to preview. This is the full sequence. Looks like it. Let's go to 400 just in case. Yep, that's the full sequence there. So it looks like it was 300. That's good. So what we'll do is we'll take this. We can actually right-click on this and say duplicate shot. So this will just take everything that's inside of here and duplicate it. Before we were going to the content browser to duplicate it, but we could duplicate it right here inside of sequencer. So I'm going to say duplicate shot. And let's point it to cinematics. We'll call it shot 02. Like so. Then I'm going to take shot 02, drag and drop it underneath shot 01. So it is essentially the same shot right on top of each other. And I'm going to scrub backwards a little bit to frame, let's say frame 125-ish. Yeah, 125-ish. That looks good. So we're going to cut right here, actually. And there's a couple things we can do. So for shot 01 here, we can right-click, and we can go to Edit, and there's a couple options for splitting, trimming, left or right. So split this particular shot into two, split and trim whatever is to the right of the marker, split and trim whatever is to the left of the marker. In this instance, we're going to split and trim right, so go ahead and select that. And then we could take shot 02 if we select it. We could use the right-click method, or there's some keyboard shortcuts. If we hold Control and hit backslash, that will split. If we have our track selected here and we hit Control period, that will split and trim right, which we just did a minute ago. Or we can hold Control and hit comma, and that will split and trim left. So it's a handy keyboard shortcut, especially if you're editing a lot of shots in here and you're cutting and splitting and trimming, etc. Those keyboard shortcuts are pretty handy. Control comma period and backslash. So what we have now is actually shot 01 leading right into shot 02, and the animation is already there. We don't need to add the character or animations. All we need to do now is go into shot 02 and change the camera because these are two separate assets inside the content browser. So I'm going to go to frame 125, go into shot 02, and actually going to delete the camera cuts track and the camera actor because we're going to show you a different way of adding cameras. So before, we went to cinematic. We took a camera in to the level, we then added it to sequencer, we then went under here and we added a camera cut track, then told the camera cut track to use that camera. That's quite a few steps. That was the manual way of doing things. Another shortcut that we can use is right here on the toolbar, which is this camera icon here. And this will do all of those steps for us with one button click. So when we click this, it will add a camera cuts, tell the camera cut to use the camera that is also added. It will also pilot the camera for us so that we can just go right in and frame our shot right away. So it's a really handy shortcut here. So go ahead and click this. And like I mentioned, there's our camera cuts, there's our camera, and we are currently piloted. So all we need to do now is just frame up our shot. So I'm going to fly down here. And before we frame up our shot, there's two things that I wanted to point out here. First of all, our camera that we've added is not using the exact same film back settings that we used for our first camera, and we're going to want those to match. So I'm going to change this. The film back settings, I believe we used a custom one that was 20 by 12. So now we can frame in our shot and it will be a consistent film back setting. Our character is out of focus, which we'll fix in a moment here. But there's one thing that I wanted to illustrate here. So if we look at our camera actor inside of sequencer, it has this little lightning bolt icon attached to it. In fact, if we look at shot 01 here, it doesn't have that. So what does that mean? Shot 02 is using a spawnable camera. What we mean by that is if we drag off of shot 02 completely, this now turns red. It has not spawned in the world yet. this camera is owned by this level sequence. It is spawned when this level sequence is created or played back, and goes away when the sequence is over. And spawnables are useful if you have actors that you want to use in multiple levels or only want to appear at a certain time in your scene. You can use them as spawnables. And you could do that with a checkbox here. You could say whether it's spawned or not. It's just a keyframe that you can uncheck and then add a keyframe for. But it's very useful if you want to use actors in multiple levels or have control over when they appear in a scene, which our bear we're going to create as a spawnable as well. So in here, I'm going to go back to frame 125. That's where this shot will take place. We dragged off of the spawnable. One thing to note, when you're using a camera as a spawnable, if you despawn it by dragging off it, you're going to lose the pilot mode. So we're going to get that back just by clicking this icon here. We're going to make sure that our film back settings, again, is set to 20 by 12, like so. And let's actually hold control and press S to save. This may be a bug, actually, that Sequencer is currently in, still in development. Features are still coming in, but it looks like this might be a bug that this isn't actually getting saved after adding a spawnable. So in pilot mode, let's go down. Let's frame up our shot. Our shot is going to be something like this, focused in on this little furnace here, kind of blocking the door. So with our shot in position, I'm going to hit S to add a keyframe for that. Going to go to the focus settings, expand this. Going to go down to the manual focus settings here and click this eyedropper. And I don't know if I mentioned this before, the eyedropper cannot be used in the cinematic viewport. It can only be used in the default viewport. So if we were framed up on our character here, I couldn't actually sample from this. I can only sample from over here. So go ahead and click that to sample from that. And we could add a keyframe for this inside of Sequencer here. There's our manual focus distance. We could add a keyframe by clicking this. Or over in the details panel, anytime you see this icon here, that means that you can add a keyframe for that property to an open level sequence. So I'm going to click this here, and that will add a keyframe for us. So our character is in focus. We've established that the shot is going to take place from the ground here. And if we scrub ahead, I'm actually going to make sure that we're locked to this as well so that we see the cinematic preview. If we scrub ahead here to where our character stands up, somewhere around frame 2, let's do frame 225. I'm going to take our pilot camera, right click, hold the right mouse button and press E to kind of pan up. You can even push in and on your character if you want a little bit, something like that. Once you're happy, just go ahead and press S, add a keyframe. So our camera kind of does that. Kind of gets up with our character. Okay. We'll scrub ahead a little bit more to about frame 277, it looks like. That is the end of this character's animation. So at this point, we're going to want to be shifted to the right. So I'm going to hold the right mouse button and press D. Kind of pan over, kind of pitch it down, maybe even pull back a little bit just to get our character in view a little bit better. Something like this. Then I'm going to press S to add a keyframe for that. So we have some movement kind of like this. Like so. And at this point, our bear is going to be back there kind of growling, looking pretty ferocious. So let's actually add him. Let's go to the content browser for this. I'm going to unpilot this camera for now. And I'm going to go to the adversaries, enemy bear. And I'm going to take that bear and place him in the level. But before I do that, we're going to make that bear a spawnable. And there's a quick shortcut for this as well. If I click on the bear here, and then I hold the shift key, and then I left click with shift held down and drag the bear into the scene. That will add the bear to Sequencer automatically, and it will also add it as a spawnable, indicated by the lightning bolt there. So it's been added to the scene. So I'm gonna scrub back a little bit to, was it one frame 125? And let's go ahead and take our bear and kind of position him how we want. So I'm gonna move him over just a little bit, press E, rotate him, W, back a little bit maybe, something like that. Looks good, so he's right in the middle of the door there. With our bear selected, I'm gonna press S to add, initialize his transform. Now if we scrub ahead, there's our bear. Let's make sure that he's idling. So I'm gonna go and add an animation for him. His animation is going to be an idle. So. And we'll notice that the idle animation for the bear does not quite reach the end of the scene. So he's kind of just standing there. We could loop this, but instead what I'm going to do is just push this over. Because he's, for the most part, hidden by our character as he's standing up. So you don't actually see him until... you still don't even see him there, really, it looks like. So that looks good. I'm actually going to see if I can push this all the way to 200. Let's see. Yeah, I still don't see him, really. He's kind of did a good job of blocking. So now our bear is idling. It looks a little bit more ferocious as the camera pans over. Last thing that we'll do is shift focus from this character to this character here. So let's go ahead and go back to about frame two. Let's say frame 230, maybe. Let's try 235. So frame 235, I'm totally winging this, by the way. Frame 235, let's pick our eyedropper. Well, before we do that, let's fly back and make sure that we can select our grunt here. Take the eyedropper, select our grunt, which he was already in focus anyway, I guess it didn't matter. Click the add button for the keyframe. Scrub ahead to the end of the scene, which will actually be right there. It's going to be pretty short. 277. Stick our eyedropper, click it, select our bear, so he comes into focus, add a keyframe. So it kind of shifts over to him. And the reason we're not too worried about adding an animation for him is we're going to do that in a separate cut. Because so this is going to be the end of our shot when it gets to there, 277. So let's go ahead and do this last shot before we wrap up this video. It's going to be very similar to what we just did, actually. We're going to duplicate shot 02, and then we're going to extend the idle animation for the bear and add an idle animation for him before we close out this video. So I'm going to go up to the master level here, and I'm going to take shot 02 here, right-click on it, and say duplicate shot. I'm going to click off cinematics, go back to cinematics, take shot 02, and just change it to shot 03, like so. Gonna take shadow 3, put it on top, like so. Very similar to what we just did. We said 277 is where we want to split, so I'm gonna take shadow 3 here, control comma, cut left, and control period, trim right. So it's now it's just an extension. The bear continues right where he left off in shadow 3, perfect. So now we need to do is go into shadow 3, add an idle animation for him, maybe loop that a little bit longer so he gets a full loop in. Yeah, let's go ahead and do that, and then we'll close out this video. So shadow 3, gonna go inside here. And let's see, let's delete our camera cut. Let's delete our camera actor. Let's add an animation for the grunt here, which is called idle. Goes right up to the 400 marker, looks like. Looks good. And for the bear, I'm just gonna loop. Let's loop this out. It's not going to get a full. Let's stretch this out. Let's make sure he gets a full idle in. I don't know if I mentioned this before. I think I did. But this marker here is the end of the animation. So that's one full idle, another full idle, and then like a quarter of an idle, which I don't want. So I'm just going to do two full idles like so. The grunt, that's fine. For him, I'll actually do half because we're going to shoot a different shot at the end of this. Because his idol isn't as crazy as the bear's, it looks like. Yeah, that's perfect. So I'm going to go to the end of these. It's like 468. I'm going to hit the, right close bracket? Is that what it's called? Or this icon there. Last thing we need to do is add our camera and adjust the movement, and then we should be done. So for this, let's go ahead and click the camera button. Boom. So now we have the camera actor. And then we have the camera cuts. Let's change our focus settings for this to 20 by 12. I'm going to hit Control S to save that just in case. And whenever I save, that looks like another bug. Whenever I save, it takes the focus off. It takes me out of pilot mode. Interesting. So I'm going to pitch it down. It's going to be something like this. I'm going to press G in this viewport as well. Just so we hide the markers. It's going to be something like this. I think that looks good. It's going to go away when I move. Should have moved the marker back further. first. Dang it. So let's go up to the master level. Let's go to 277, jump into Shadow 3. Now let's go into pilot mode on our camera here. Set it up the way we want. So something like this. Like that. Add a keyframe for our camera when it's selected. Press S. So now we won't lose it as we move around. Perfect. Now we can scrub ahead. Go to the end, actually, all the way to the end. Right mouse button down, W to fly forward, and just kind of move in on our bear here. Something low, so he's looking kind of ferocious. Something like this. I'm going to press S, add a keyframe for that. I'm also going to change the focal distance at this point. Click the eyedropper, select our bear, add a keyframe. And let's see what that looks like. I'm going to go back to the master level here. We may need to stretch our master scene out here because I don't think it's going to play all the way through. Nope, sure isn't. So let's take this, stretch that out, and see. So it actually ends at like 468. So I'm going to control period that, right close bracket, and now our scene should have three shots in it. Let's take a look at it from the beginning real quick. So he's kind of sitting down, and then he kind of gets up. Looks pretty cool. Looking pretty good. All right, that's going to do it for this video, actually. We're going to pause here. We're going to pick it back up in the next video where we continue on with the rest of the animation for our scene. We're going to show you a different workflow. So far, what we've been doing is we've created on a shot-by-shot basis. What we're going to do next is create the rest of the fight scene, create all the animation, and then come back and then set up the cameras a little bit later. So it's just a different way of approaching things. So we're going to pause here, and we'll pick it back up in the next video where we continue with our cinematic. Thank you guys for watching.